The usual race card hustlers are now braying that the American people's demands for free, fair, and secure elections in their states are tantamount to, you guessed it, white nationalism.
And Rev, this is nothing short to me of white nationalism in action in our political system. It's anti-democracy, but it's anti a specific kind of democracy. The guy who's leading, the newest lawyer involved in this, is a guy named John Eastman, a professor at Chapman University, and a birther who tried a birther attack on Kamala Harris. They're only going after cities where there's a predominance of black voters and saying that's where the fraud is. Am I wrong on this? Because I see this as a direct war against black voters.
You're absolutely right on this. When you look at where they have methodically gone after black voting districts, black voting areas, they're not questioning all of the votes in a state or even a city, but they've targeted certain areas. They are directly trying to disenfranchise and criminalize black voters.
But who targeted the Democrat urban machines in those black neighborhoods in the first place? As we reported to you here on Sovereign Nation weeks before the election, it was Silicon Valley-funded nonprofit groups like the Mark Zuckerberg-subsidized Center for Tech and Civic Life that poured tens and hundreds of millions of dollars into cities like Milwaukee, Detroit, and Philadelphia to promote ballot harvesting, mobile voting, and other fraud-friendly election initiatives under the guise of COVID.
We're going to pull up a map here because it looks like it's happening everywhere. But as you say, the stress here is on key battleground states. Can you talk, for example, what they're doing in Philadelphia?
Well, Philadelphia, it's quite remarkable. They poured $10 million into Philadelphia. And now Philadelphia is deputizing new election clerks. And they're going around, they have mobile ballot pickup in Philadelphia, where Hillary Clinton won over 70% of the vote. And additionally, that mobile pickup is contrary to state law.
So loudmouth Al Sharpton thinks it's racist to question election obstruction and manipulation in urban areas. But just remember, he and his ilk had nothing to say about militant new Black Panther Party thugs wielding billy clubs outside a Philadelphia voting station in 2008.
I think it might be a little bit intimidating that you have a stick in your hand. That's why, you know?
Yes.
No, I'm an attorney.
I mean, that's a weapon, so that's why I'm a little worried.
Who are you to decide?
I mean, I am a concerned citizen, and I'm just worried that you might be...
So are we.
Okay.
That's why we're here.
Okay, but you have a nightstick in your hand.
12 years later, the people are fighting back. And whatever happens to the Supreme Court, election reform demanded by citizens is here to stay.
You just watched Newsmax TV, America's fastest growing cable news channel, now in more than 70 million homes. You can get Newsmax TV on your cable system or check your cable guide. And if your system doesn't carry Newsmax, call them, tell them you want Newsmax TV, because we're real news for real people.